You need us.
So worried.
Silence is lonely.
We didn't know where you'd gone.
We're here to help you.
Don't worry. You can trust us.
Trust us.
Senua, it's us. We won't leave you.
Hello.
Don't leave us. We're here to stay.
There's a way in.
Into the mountain.
Can you see it?
Shall we tell her where to go?
Does she know her way into the mountain?
She's a good girl.
Oh, isn't she?
Look up. So clever.
Did you miss us?
Oh, she did. She did.
Are you glad we're back?
She's so glad we're back. Go
we
on.
Know which way to go? Look
go up. Up. Go up. Go up into the mountain.
There's a door.
You can do it.
You can see it.
Come on, Senua.
Go away. I'm not listening.
I will tell you of a great hero named Sigurd, son of Sigmund, no less. Born after his father's death, Sigurd is cared for by the dwarf, Reyn. But Reyn does not love the boy. Instead, he plans to use him for his own ends. You see, Reyn's father possessed a great treasure given to him by the gods. But Reyn's brother, Fafnir, killed his father and took the gold all for himself. Fafnir hid the treasure out on a heath and could not leave it. And from the evil in his heart, he turned into a dark creature. A dragon.
You're moving towards your death.
it.
She can feel it.
No.
Don't open the door.
No, go in. Don't open the door.
What's it?
Get back! A great beast guards Helheim. Garm is its name, and it knows you are here, Senua. It can smell your stink. What are you afraid of, Senua? How will you save Dillion if you are too much of a coward to step into the shadows?
They can't stop me.
Then do it.
Run! Run!
Is stalking you from the shadows. Your sword is useless here.
Senua, it's so loud.
It's not her.
Just so full of hate.
It's a trap.
I just want to help them. Tell me what to do.
Your father wants them to go away. And he only hurts me to silence them.
But he's gone now.
But they always come back. He says I will die if I go with them. They say that I'm already dead.
No,
and that they want me with them.
Stop!
That's why they crawl through the walls.
Don't listen
to them.
Do you
see them? Do you see their faces?
He's coming! Senua! Help me! Help! Get me out of here! Don't go!
Where has she gone? She's disappeared again.
She shouldn't be here. She escaped the darkness. She took her own life to escape it.
She can't remember when it started. When her mother lost her smile. Her eyes gazing past her towards a world she could not see. This is what happens if you reach for the underworld, he said. It was a lot to take in for a child. And the first time she felt the cold chill of fear. I don't talk much about her father, Zimbel. I suppose I just didn't want to risk upsetting her. But it doesn't matter now, does it?
You have it.
Keep going. lighting the torch.
It's not going to help her.
She's lighting the light. Tenderness. It's insane.
Oh,
She'll have to go under.
She
has to.
She can't.
The torch will go out.
Don't let the torch go out.
She can do it.
You can do it. She can't do it.
The light's gone out. Run. Run. Get through it as quick as you can. The panic is here.
What was that?
She has it.
She did it. Look, she's done it.
Well done.
This place, it reminds her of the isolating, suffocating darkness that she lived through as a young girl. Imprisoned in her room at night, the faces in the dark, coming through the walls. She once thought everyone could see them. I mean, that's what children say all the time, isn't it? There are monsters in the dark. By the time she realized that only she could see them, her father, Zinbel, could see the monster in her.
Rayan the Dwarf's sole desire is to possess this dragon's accursed treasure, and he uses Sigurd to reclaim it. He tells Sigurd the story of Fafnir's gold, and the good-hearted hero promises to slay the dragon if Rayan would forge a strong sword for him. Sigurd remembers that his father once possessed a sword given to him by Odin, Odin broke the sword to bring about Sigmund's death, but Sigurd's mother still has the pieces. And so Rhian reforges the famous sword. Sigurd uses the sword first to avenge his father, and then he and Rhian go in search of Fafnir.
Did you see her die? I don't remember. I was only 5. They told me she escaped the darkness. That she's with the gods. But what if they lied? What if the darkness took her and trapped her here?
Where is her mother? It's just her mother. Stupid girl!
It's a trap. The beast is coming. Stupid thing.
Run away from the
child at the hands of your father, Zindo, while you pined for Divian. Do you remember the darkness, Senua? The beast is bringing it back.
Mother, why did you leave me? Spreading. Father's keeping me away from the others. Away from Tilly. I won't give up. I'm not going to rot in here. I'm going to find Dillian.
Is down there.
No.
She knows the beast is down there. She can climb towards
him. He's always watching you.
Never say fine.
You can feel him.
Be careful. You might be
wrong. She needs to find Dillian.
She can.
She lost it and she has to find it.
Where is it?
The torch alight.
No, she isn't.
over.
Finish it.
She wouldn't listen.
He was doing his best.
She never, ever listens.
Why didn't she listen to him?
He was trying to save her from the dark. Zindel was right. Zindel was trying to save her from the dark.
But she wouldn't listen.
Never choose a bit.
And now everybody is dead.
Because of her. It's all her fault.
All her.
She should have known. She should have.
Why doesn't she learn?
She will she learn? She doesn't understand.
Now the darkness has Dillian's soul.
and it will take it and never give it back.
She can search and search, but she will not.
She's let the darkness in. It's the end.
The darkness will take her like it took her mother.
She can't resist. Pointless even trying to retrieve it. She's lost.
Where is she going? She's got to go deeper to find the head. Deeper towards the darkness.
The beast is there. The beast is luring her deeper, deeper into the darkness.
The dragon Fafnir is so large and deadly that it would be impossible to kill him face to face. But each day, Fafnir crawls across the heath to find water. So Sigurd digs a pit in the dragon's path and lies in wait in it. When Fafnir slithers overhead, Sigurd sinks his sword into the dragon up to the hilt. Sigurd leaps from the pit, and Fafnir sees his killer. He warns Sigurd that the treasure will lead to his death, as it led to the death of all who owned it. Sigurd replies that death comes to all men, and every man would want to be wealthy until that day. And he takes the treasure. Kills the dragon. Rian wants to keep Fafnir's gold all for himself. Rian also wants the strength and wisdom of the dragon, so he drinks its blood and asks Sigurd to roast Fafnir's heart for him. Sigurd does so, but when he touches the roasted heart to see if it is done, he burns his finger. Without thinking, he licks his finger and tastes the dragon's blood. In that moment, he understands the language of birds and hears them talk nearby.
What's she doing?
She's lighting a torch.
She's making light. She's making a fire.
She's got light on the other side.
She'll be safe. What's her plan?
What's her plan? I've
got to get there.
Faster, faster, keep going, keep going.
What is she doing?
Stop!
Now she can go.
Stop!
Stop letting the memories
in. Stop letting the memories
in. Follow
you.
Quick. Where is she going?
Faster, faster, keep going, keep going.
What is she doing?
Stop!
Stop letting the memories in.
Stop letting the memories in. Follow you.
Quick. Faster, faster, keep going.
Where is she going?
Faster, faster, keep going, keep going. What is she doing?
Stop!
Stop letting
the memories
in.
Stop letting the memories
in. Follow you.
Quick.
Where is she going?
Faster, faster, keep going, keep going.
Help but think of him. A tender guiding flame in a world so black. The longer it burned, the more she convinced herself that there was nothing beyond its reach. How little separates us from what we fear.
Spamner's gold. Sigurd should kill Rian before Rian kills him. Sigurd heeds the bird's advice. He kills Rian, eats Fafnir's roasted heart, and takes Fafnir's treasure. And he embarks on a new quest. To ride to Hinderfell and find Brynhild, the Valkyrie.
Go quickly.
Thank you.
people think of evil as an unnatural, invisible force, and so invoke the gods for protection. But evil can come from the hand behind the gods. A familiar hand. Cold and cruel. He tried to fix her with his rituals. Kept her trapped in that hole. She couldn't say which was worse. The darkness. Or the monster that her father had become. She couldn't fight them both. And so she left. Headed for the one ray of light that shone down on her. If she had stayed, she wouldn't have survived. But maybe Delian would still be alive.
I'm so sorry, my love.
She will save his soul, even if this time she can't save her own.
Forgive me, Senua. I know you have no reason to trust me anymore.
Shadow, listen.
But believe this. It was my mission to make you hate. To hate the darkness with a passion so great it would focus your mind on this quest. All about it. I fear you have left those flat. All this time, I've wanted to protect you from the truth that would have destroyed you a long time ago. But you have conquered your darkness at every turn. You deserve to see behind the veil of darkness.
And take me to the master
to trust you.
As deep as we can go.
I won't stand in your way.
She has to trust him.
You will not survive what is in there.
I know.
What else can she do?